गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू सोशल स्टडीज ट्यूटोरियल। सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर लर्निंग चैप्टर 4 ऑफ ज्योग्राफी एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज मैप्स। सो इन आर लास्ट सेशन वी हैव लर्न दैट व्हाट अ मैप इज। सो व्हाट अ मैप इज, अ मैप इज अ टू डायमेंशनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द अर्थ और द पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ which is drawn to a scale on the surface. So that is a map. Then we have also talked about some of the limitations of globe, because like in our first chapter we have talked about globe, so we are quite familiar with the limitations of a globe and how means it makes easier the uses of the maps. So afterwards we have talked about the different types of maps. So what we have learned, that there are the different types of maps, like the physical maps, political maps, thematic maps or the cadastral maps. So in today's session now, what we have to learn, the components of a map. Though we have learned its different types, but how, what exactly the components, what the requirement should be there. So a map should be included these like components to make it like a very friendly or easy to understand. So what the components are? A title, scale, direction, latitudes and longitudes. I hope that is also, you are also familiar with this latitudes and longitudes, because we have like while learning globe, then we have talked about these latitudes and lines of longitudes, and then the key or legend. So these are the important components of a. Now let's understand these components of a map in details. The first is title. So students, when the term title just comes before us, then what? It clearly says that what the content is all about. So similarly, it happens there in case of a map, that the title states the purpose or theme of the map, that what the map is all about. For example, that India is there is political map for world, physical or Chennai. If we talk about, then there are the road map. So what exactly, these are the titles which clearly states the purpose or the theme of the map. Then the next component, that is scale. So why, what do you think, like why we use scale while like just having the concept of map? Because when we talk about scale, when we talk about maps, then what happens? Because it is a two-dimensional representation of the earth or the part of the earth. So while measuring that the distance of the ground on a scale, so it is very necessary. So what exactly, that scale is quite required to ensure that the map is just to show the distance between places very accurately, and this can only be done with the help of a scale. So the scale of a map, here now the scale of a map is defined as the ratio between the distance on the map and the corresponding distance on the ground, because it clearly tells us about the actual distance of that place which we are going to indicate there on the map. So a scale is the relationship. What we can conclude, that the scale is the relationship between distance on the map and distance on the ground. So once we just try to represent these relationships, so what we require, we require scale. And like for example, suppose if the market is at a distance of 5 kilometers, so what do you think? Can we stretch our map for 5 kilometers? No, we can't. So in that case, what we reduce it to 5 centimeters, because what we assume on a map, that 5 centimeters distance on the map is equal to an actual distance of 5 kilometers on the ground. So this is just because of the purpose that we require scale. And the scale of a map can be represented in different ways. What are the different ways? These are the verbal or statement scale, representative fraction. So what a linear scale. So what a verbal or statement scale is? that it describes the scale in words. Here we are talking about words. For example, 1 centimeter on the map is equal to 1 kilometer on the ground. So 1 centimeter scale to 1 kilometer distance on the earth's surface, that is in terms of words, verbal or statement scale. Whereas representative fraction, so representative fraction represents the scale of a map in terms of a fraction or a ratio between the distance on the map. Here we are talking about representative fraction. So what exactly representative fraction? That it tells about the distance on the map. Here we are talking about the ratio distance on the map and the actual distance on the ground. Actual distance. Now, for example, suppose here in map, we are talking about 1 centimeter represents 1 kilometers. Just understand very clearly that 1 centimeter on the map represents 1 kilometers. So how? Because here we are talking about representative fraction. So how can we convert it into fraction? That it says the ratio that represent 1 centimeters, what exactly? In 1 kilometer there is 1 lakh centimeters. So what we have to do, we have to write down like this. So this is the fraction of 1 centimeters, which is equal to 1 kilometer of distance. So or what exactly we can say, that it is the ratio, and the ratio is 1 is to 1 lakh. Now the next is linear scale. So what a linear scale is? It is one where the scale of map is represented by a straight line. Linear scale. Linear, that means the term is the first L-I-N-E. That means line. So in a straight line with uniformly spaced divisions. So the divisions of on the extreme left of the scale is further graduated to show the subdivisions of the main unit of measures. So these subdivisions help us to measure even smaller lengths than the main unit. Now the next is large scale and small scale maps. So maps are also classified as large scale and small scale maps. So what exactly the large scale or small scale maps? The large scale maps cover smaller land on the map, smaller land area. Here we are talking about large scale, though it is large, but it covers a smaller land area on the map and provide a great deal of detail, that most of the details are mentioned there. Whereas small scale maps cover larger land area on the map and provides very small amount of details. So this one was the components of a map. So students, we have learned these two components. In today's session, we'll continue the remaining three in our next session. Till the time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.